Hey guys, this is Alachia, and I wanted to thank a couple of you guys who tweeted and messaged me yesterday the Kurt Scott's video on optimistic nihilism. I've actually been a very, very long time subscriber of Kurt Scott's before it was Kurt Scott's in a nutshell. And one of my favorite videos that they've ever done is on the death of the universe. But it was really awesome that so many people were like, hey, check out this video, Alachi. I think you'll like it. It's like, you guys are starting to get me, man. It's really awesome. So the video on optimistic nihilism was really about our place in the universe as human beings. And it also touches on what it's like to accept your present moment in time, knowing that in the scope of all time in the universe, your existence is so almost utterly meaningless. And actually, ironically, it's actually one of their most optimistic videos that they've done. Just recently, a few weeks ago, they did one on automation and the role of AI and how AI is going to affect the job market for humans in the near future. And then that I also saw in conjunction to that, just a day or so ago, an article that was this ongoing debate between Mark Zuckerberg and Elon Musk and Bill Gates about whether or not we are approaching an AI doomsday, whether or not the increased, progression of AI is going to eventually really have a vast effect on human beings and their role in the world. And so that kind of reminded me of a series I've been wanting to review for a very, very long time. Back when I did my Westworld review, The Curious Incident 1 put a comment in my review saying, Alachia, you have to watch Humans. It's exactly the kind of thing that you'd like. And this person was so right, and thank you so much for the recommendation. So it is on Amazon Prime season 1 and season 2. It aired back in 2015. It is a British series that was produced on Channel 4 based off of the Swedish series, and I think it aired in the US on AMC. So this is a parallel universe. The series takes place in a parallel universe where there is this a massive production of what they call synths, which are super, super advanced robots that are very, very human-like, who have taken over so many of the jobs that humans have always had in the industrial world, in the healthcare world, in the service sectors, in the sex services sectors. And there's just an array of incorporation of these synths as like the normal household appliance. Everyone has one. You have them as your maid, as your nanny, as your cook. And this series follows a particular kind of suburban family named the Hawkins, who finally decide to get a synth. The husband does, Joe, and they pick up a synth named Anita. And it's about the incorporation of the synth into their lives, as well as addressing other issues about a couple of synths that may or may not be approaching sentience or already have sentience. What's really fascinating about this show is that at its core, it is a mystery thriller, but it constantly incorporates this philosophical contemplation of the role of humans with superior AI, and constantly asks this question of whether or not the rise of AI equals the fall of mankind. And it's just done so well, and it gives you a lot of like real life situations where you start to look and you see the technology, and you do look back and say, it does our growing dependence on technology and the convenience of technology eventually mean an outcome in which the technology replaces us completely? And then can we find meaning outside of that and beyond that? So very, very fascinating stuff. At the same time, there also is a subplot of what we consider sentient life, what we actually consider what is sentient, because some of the AI exhibit what a lot of people might consider sentient behavior. And the question is, what is life after that? And can we define life beyond an organic biological form? So super fascinating. It's highly, highly recommended if this is the type of topic that you really are into. If you enjoyed Westworld or Ex Machina, this is definitely a show for you. It is streaming on Amazon Prime. I think, season one and season two. And I believe AMC just ordered up season three, which will come out in 2018. Yeah. So let me know if you guys, if you watch it, I'd highly recommend it if you watch it. And let's discuss that below. But if you want me to do a season two review, because I have a whole different take on season two, because it explores a whole new set of themes. But if you want me to do a season two review, let me know in the comments below, and then we can talk about that. So yeah, highly, highly recommend Humans. It's something I've been wanting to recommend to you guys for a really long time. For me, it's definitely an A+ series. It's brilliant. The acting is really great in it too. Neil Mascal, totally fell in love with him from this series. He plays a detective who's investigating a murder. William Hurt is in this, and he is a scientist who's also dealing with like what it's like to live life with kind of the oppressive synth technology in your life. And then the beautiful, gorgeous Gemma Chan, who plays the synth Anita, who's incorporated into the Hawkins family. All of the actors who played the synths played it perfectly. They got that, you know, synthetic human robot movement down. I did spend a couple weeks after this series completely mimicking them. It must have been very annoying for Zixa. I'm sorry, I do not understand the question. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side.